Rowena. I'm Director of Counseling here at Highland Park Counseling, and welcome to HP Midweek. And I would like to talk a little bit about anxiety. And unfortunately, it is one of the topics that most people are familiar with at least once in their life or sometimes in their life. And it's a subject that we could spend hours on, but we're just gonna spend a few minutes here talking about some of the basics. So there are multiple forms of anxiety and multiple ways to address it, but we're going to talk about four different types here. Okay, so anxiety is often experienced in physical ways. So you can experience anxiety like your heart racing, shortness of breath, dizziness, your stomach might feel funny. You might have other digestive issues. Sometimes people feel like, you know, very restless. They might not be able to concentrate very well. It's other people describe like a pit in their stomach sometimes when they experience anxiety. So it can be very distracting as well. Like if you are anxious and someone else is trying to talk to you, you're distracted, you can't concentrate. So those are all the different ways that anxiety can manifest. So the first reason for that you could be experiencing anxiety is that you have too many activities going on at one time, that you're overwhelmed by your daily activities. So basically, you have too many obligations, you have too many things on your plate, and often you feel like you have to do all those activities. There's a lot of, I have to do this, and I have to do that, or I should be doing this, and I should be doing that. And you try to multitask them and juggle all of those things, and eventually a lot of tension and stress build up. And I've actually seen people get panic attacks from trying to do all of those things, just having too many things on their plate. So some of the ways of addressing that is by learning how to slow down. I know it's easier said than done, but you try to slow down your life and take an assessment of what's really important. You might have to talk through that with someone, and it may not be easy, but it's definitely worth it. Another part is learning how to draw the line. You need to learn how to draw the line at a certain point. Like at work, you might have to say, you know, I'm gonna stop here. It's 7 o'clock, I'm not gonna do any more work on this computer anymore or on this job anymore. You might have to draw the line with certain people in your life as well. And I really recommend a book, and there might even be a course called Boundaries by Cloud and Townsend. And that is one way that you can learn how to find what appropriate boundaries to draw in your life, especially if you're trying to juggle too many things at one time. And another reason for anxiety, the second reason I want to cover, is that you might be avoiding some things that you shouldn't be avoiding. This is something that people don't really think about. And a lot of times it's not necessarily conscious that you're avoiding these things. So there's some issues that you might need to talk about in your life. It could be different relational issues, especially with maybe your grown children, maybe your children, maybe your spouse, could be friendships. It could be anything really that you're avoiding, and you don't want to talk about it because it's unpleasant. And so you think by suppressing them and by avoiding it that you're helping yourself, but you're actually building up tension in another area. Our emotions just don't go away when we ignore them. They come out in a different way, and a lot of times it'll come out in anxiety, unfortunately. So it's really important to face them, and it's important to address those issues. And so you may need to talk to someone, and I'd say a wise friend that doesn't create more anxiety would be helpful. But you may need to talk to a therapist to really face what you've been avoiding. Another reason for anxiety, it's the third reason that we're covering, is that you're afraid of something bad happening in the future. This could actually be performance of something, like public speaking, for instance. Like what I'm doing here could make someone very nervous, and it made me a little bit nervous. I'll be real with you for a minute. But it is a common fear. So sometimes we have performance anxieties, and a lot of times we just have to face it. We have to do that. We need to face the we need just to face the fears behind it. Sometimes people think they might look stupid or that they're not going to have the words or whatever it may be, but it's important to talk through those fears. But another form of fear of the future might be even a little bit more serious than that, is where you fear bad things happening to your friends or your family, your loved ones. You're afraid of getting sick, or you're afraid of an accident happening, especially if that's happened before for you. And those are actually very important to address, especially the what ifs about the situation. So you may need to face the fears that you have regarding those situations that you're afraid of. And it's important to address that again with a person, talking through them. And I think one especially important or good way of talking through them is through cognitive behavioral therapy. It's a type of therapy that addresses your perspective and your mindset when it comes to those issues. So a final reason for anxiety, and it's actually a pretty big reason, and often sad, is that you might have undealt with trauma in your life. And again, it will probably manifest itself physically. There might be some sort of trigger that you experience, and then you have the physical feeling. You'll have the heart racing, you'll feel scared. You might have even a disgusted feeling related to a memory. And what can be confusing sometimes about trauma is that you might not experience or even know that you need to deal with that until later on. It could lie dormant for a long time, and then there could be a series of events in your life that unfortunately bring it up and trigger it. And one example of that is a birth of a child, which is actually a good thing. But it could be, I'm using this as an example, it could be the thing that triggers maybe your own childhood memories or your own fears of and your own experiences, particular memories that were really difficult. And so these undealt with traumas sometimes catch up with us, unfortunately. And there's other traumas sometimes, like car accidents and things like that, that bring up anxiety as well, that are important to deal with. And there are particular therapies that are actually aimed towards those kinds of memories, that where it's a memory that is actually painful. And there's something called EMDR, eye movement desensitization and reprocessing. We actually do here at Highland Park. A couple of us counselors do it here, and that deals with very specific memories to make them less painful. And then there's another one that some other therapists do that's also very effective, called RTM, and that's called reconsolidation of trauma memories. Again, RTM. So those are some very specific therapies aimed at trauma and those memories there. It's very effective, so I, if you have that, I encourage you to seek that out. So anxiety really isn't something that we have to suffer with. There are ways to address it, and ignoring it doesn't help at all. It's important to face those fears, to face what is bothering you, because it will only build, unfortunately, if you ignore it. And so it doesn't have to be debilitating at all. I encourage you to reach out and to find the help that you need. And I would just like to thank you for listening, and just pray that you guys have an awesome week.